Just run along, Jean, and do whatever it is that subconscious recessional forms do.
Just look at me. Look at me. I am trained to get inside the criminal mind, and now I'm stuck in my own with you! Whoopee!
Just relax, okay? Chris, I know how this goes. Hunt the bullish one, raise the misogynistic one, and you're the nervous one, blah, blah, blah. I don't care. There you go.
You're pissed.
And you are a bloody figment.
What was that? Right there in the speedboat with the machine gun. Was that you being cool?
Will you just shut up and listen to me? This is my bloody fantasy and I will be listened to.
You show us yours, we show you ours.
In your dreams. And if you continue to bang on about it, I'm going to have to reimagine you. It's not real. Nobody will ever know but me and my therapist. Obviously, I wouldn't do this in real life. I don't shag such a right businessman, no matter how cute they are. I'm merely going to piss off that part of the id that spewed up my mother. And nobody will know but me. Piss off, you lardy fascist.
I could use a woman like you.
I think you already have.
Just because I am stuck here doesn't mean I have to pretend to like it.
You feel better now?
No. Better now.
You should get help.
Yeah, and you should get some manners.
How's the hangover?
Yeah, it's coming along nicely. How's your chin?
What do you want me to morph into a nun? It's not like I've shagged an entire rugby team, is it?
Tell him you think women like me are dirty. Tell him you think I'm like a prostitute. You've got no respect for women like that. In fact, Jean, just be yourself.
I've asked Ray and Chris to keep an eye on that girl who keeps hanging around the station.
What, Nina? What's she done to deserve them?
Plenty of opportunity, though. Friend of the family is always round here. Late nights with case studies, cheese and wine. Let's have another one, Evan. Daddy's away. I know, let's do it. Let's do it here on the floor. Was I up? Was your daughter asleep? Was she sleeping upstairs while you were shagging her godfather?
I don't appreciate...
And I don't appreciate your lies! You are a bloody liar!
They have sex genes, sweaty, muscular male sex. Just get used to it. Now, can we concentrate, please, on the crimes he commits and not whose cock he sucks?
Did you just say...
Yes, Chris, I did. Of course, the other reason for your rampant homophobia could be that you're a bunch of puffers.
Told her, didn't I?
I'd shag him if he'd let me.
Why don't we break open a bottle of champers? Bolly, yeah? Everybody fancy a drop of Bolly?
Does it come with knickers?
Excuse me, that is evidence.
I wouldn't worry about it because you're off the case.
Off the case?
Off the case and off the team.
Oh, off the team?
Yes. Actually, no, you can clean my car out.
I'm off the team.
Don't talk to that man, he works for Caroline Price.
I'll talk to whoever I like. Okay, good. In control. Now, none of you will die. Unless I choose to kill you.
I need everybody on side here, is that understood?
Whatever.
Whatever what?
Yes, it's understood. Timothy and Caroline Price, I'm arresting you on suspicion of the, Sorry, you're nicked. Come on. When I first came here, the idea of spending time with you filled me with horror. You're insensitive, you're boorish, you're terrified of women.
Of course, if the man was dead, he's not going to be any more dead if we get there 5 minutes later.
Oh, what are you doing down here, Sal? I'm getting your kit off for a bunch of pervy southerners.
Trying to be an actress.
That's what they all say.
Oh, was that it? I've seen bacon grilled for longer than that.
Cheat, I'm even starting to speak like you.
How's your food?
I really wouldn't know.
What do you think about Mac now?
I think he's very attractive. I think he's pulling the Met in the right direction. And I think he said the word love in a police station.
You attract nutters. I noticed that about you.
Yeah, so have I.
Of all the great career moves in all the world, I'm glad I just got to see the worst. Classic timing, Mom.
Oh, I don't need to take a career lecture from you, Carling. You were talking about a cover-up just now.
Bunch of pikers protecting one of their own.
protecting their own. Well, we can't have that, can we?
You see, the thing is, Gov, I've just told Dr. Battleford that the brakes were cut on his car, and he has expressed no surprise or shock whatsoever. Chidwick died of an overdose of sleeping pills.
Sleeping pills?
Yes, the panacea of desperate housewives.
You know, you're wasting your time, Drake.
And you're letting me down, Gov.
Oh, so it's love, actually. More like four benzos in a funeral.
Break the door down.
You're joking, are you? She's not joking.
Hey, I am your superior officer. Now, you break that door down right now!
Deaths in custody, very common now, apparently. Is that why Mac popped in? Brief you on his method.
The little pitter-patter of tiny crocodile boots. Every month, dozens of young northern kids come down to the bright lights of London. Some don't ever go back.
Oh, they can't be blamed for that. Just thought you could have done a bit better, that's all.
Well, what's wrong with her?
Well, apart from the fact she's a journalist and she's from Glasgow.
Another door is ajar, Bolly. What do we do now?
We knock it down, Gov.
It's like watching a car crash in slow motion.
Before we all get too carried away with romantic joy, can I just point out one thing?
That this is a total nightmare?
Are you insane? Piss off.
I don't answer to you. Not anymore.
But has anybody ever told you that you can't go around accusing detective inspectors of being weird, especially ones who are really pissed off?
Stop pissing us about, Mickey!
If you don't cooperate with us, I swear to you, I will personally see to it that your nuts get squeezed very tightly in a vice. So unless you want to end up with a voice like a BG, I suggest you start telling us the truth.
Well, he has to get the money for him to buy weed. He's too bloody lazy to get a job.
He's only 14.
No, he'd rather lay around in bed all day working on the novel that only exists in his head.
Have you been at the gym?
You don't know what he's like. He is untrustworthy, two-timing, two-faced, spineless, selfish little shit.
Just you wait, boys. Before you know it, you'll all be asking for a back crack and sack.
He certainly caught the attention of you three. You all lied him up.
Bloody rubbish.
No way.
No, we never.
Bollocks. And you'll probably end up sharing a cell with a great big bloke covered in scars and tattoos who'll call you his bitch. I'm just kidding.
Oh, very classy. God only knows what sort of trauma you two have put that poor woman through.
Why are you so keen for me to get involved? Feeling a bit lonely?
Oh, stop it, Donna. Tears won't help you now. You know, I'm gonna miss these nights.
You're not that bad.
What'd you do? Steam it and then seal it back up again.
Say hello to Mummy Bear.
Strange it should all end on some silly accident. Still, maybe that's the point. Sometimes bad things just happen.
This is fantastic. Bloody brilliant. Thank you, Gov. Another childhood memory ruined.
Right, think that's enough of that. Don't you?
Oh, come on, Ray. Taking one bite out of a deep-fried penis doesn't make you a bad person.
Yeah, it's third stage VD, Gov. I'm an aggressively promiscuous nymphomaniac, you know that. Could this be code?
Either that or our bent coppers are making a bluey starring Daley Thompson.
Nah, I would pay good money to see that.
You know what? So would I.
I've salvaged enough party cassettes in my time.
Okay. Stand down the techno twat. I think I've got it.
Break it down, please.
We don't have a warrant, Mom.
Warrant, Schmorra. Just do it.
Please wouldn't kill you.
You're a scummy sort of a guy, Ray.
I beg your pardon.
Where do you go to meet women? You know how many replies you're going to get, don't you?
None.
I don't recall asking for your opinion, Shaz.
You liked me young.
I am young, you rude git.
You didn't go anywhere near those twins, did you, Ray?
Yeah, I did.
No, you didn't. You've got to tell. You stroke that tash when you're lying.
Ray, this ain't his smoke inhalation.
Ray will be fine. He's been inhaling smoke since he was about 9.
What's your bra size?
Out of your league. That's my bra size.
Right, take that little stroke down to cell 3.
Oh, the one that still sticks of sick. You know what, if I was looking at spending another day in a cell that smelt of sick, I'd probably say it was the first person I saw too.
You've been putting crap in his office again?
Yeah.
It's a drugs tip-off we're chasing. If I'm going to lose my life, I'd like it to be for something a little bit more worthwhile.
He's quite a character, isn't he? He certainly knows how to wind you up.
Do I have gullible written on my forehead?
Here we go again. Because there's something called the law. Does that ring any bells? No, no, amazingly, they let us solve crimes. Whatever next day, the vote.
I am negotiating.
What, like Hiroshima's negotiated?
4 to a cell, 23-hour lockups, bucket for a toilet.
Right then, we better go and splinter some schools for Viv.
How touched he would be.
Bar opens at the front or back, Bolly.
You will never... ever, ever know, Gov.
A piece of black quartz has been put into each of the gobs.
Adding a touch of class to your gangland hit. You'd go to hell. You're the most difficult, stubborn, obnoxious, misogynistic, and reckless human being
I've ever met.